from the unpredictable multiplayer universe. This Spartan Life with your host, Damian Lacedemian.
Welcome back to This Spartan Life. We're the talk show in game space, and we've got a special extended episode for you today. Our guests, Rooster Teeth Productions, have been making Machinima since 2003, when the first episode of the massively popular Red vs. Blue premiered. They have since moved into live-action shorts, and more recently began the Achievement Hunter website, and two new Machinima series spin-offs, Fails of the Week and Achievement Horse, with Jeff Ramsey and Jack Patillo as co-hosts. In Achievement Horse, Jeff and Jack face off on a series of Halo obstacle courses, with the loser of each round given a letter in the word horse, sort of like the basketball game, but with less physical benefit. The show is a big hit already, with thousands of challenge maps submitted by gamers on Xbox Live, so we thought it was a good time to ask the guys to jump into TSL with us. Jeff and Jack, thanks for joining us. Welcome to This Spartan Life.
Hey, Damian, thanks for having us on.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
I hear you have a pretty torturous series of maps for us to go through.
I've heard nothing but terrible, terrible things.
Well, the map that you'll be competing in was designed by Pete the Duck, who's right here. Pete, do you have any warnings at all or anything?
We have a little surprise for the winner that involves doing something really humiliating to the loser.
So instead of spelling horse, we thought we'd make this a little easier and spell out TSL. This first challenge is sort of a ladder of death.
Ah.
You have to go rung by rung all the way up to the top.
While the kill ball is going up.
Exactly.
That's good that you started us off one on
standard. He said he started us off on the hard one.
Fantastic.
All right, this is easy.
I think I can see how this is going to go.
Yeah, this is going to be fun. So, you guys have about 6 hours to kill?
Yeah.
Jeff, do you want to tell us a little bit about Achievement Horse? Like, you know, for the three people in the gaming world who've never seen it?
Yeah, absolutely. Achievement Horse started one day because I literally walked into the Achievement Hunter office and challenged Jack to a game of horse on our basketball goal outside. But it was like 80 degrees, and it's a humid Austin, Texas heat, and we're not the most physically fit guys anyway, and I thought, you know what, on second thought, this sounds like a terrible idea. If only there was a way we could play horse in a video game. And so we popped a copy of Reach in, and I said, Jack, make a map and see if I can do it. I'll make something and see if you can do it. And we, in about an hour, I guess, right, Jack? We had our first round of horse, and we were instantly hooked. Ah! Somehow that was your fault, Jack, I don't know.
Oh, come on.
Oh, check out how Jack dies in perfect symmetry.
Yeah, this is a breeze, so we'll be done with this in no time.
How did the community involvement in the show begin?
So, Jack and I are terrible at Forge. And that's really sad. I understand that I've been making Red vs. Blue for 8 years, and that people think that there's some skill set involved there, but there's really not. And so we put a call out and said, hey, if anybody has a horse map they want to try, just go ahead and send it to us, and we'll give it a shot. And then we got, you know, 5 or 10,000 by the third episode, I think.
And how many interns are helping you with this?
We have one. His name's Jack.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's an indicator, then, to the skill set Jack had that made you hire him.
Yeah, lack of a social life.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Jack's moving up.
Look at that.
Look at you, Jack.
That's all I gotta do? I'm done?
Of course, we'll edit out about a million deaths, but congratulations, Jack. Jeff gets a T. And here we have the second challenge, the Rock Maze, which I think is just really beautiful to look at.
Oh, this is pretty awesome looking. Here we go. I'm gonna go first.
All right, so the whole point is just work your way across, I guess.
Yeah, downskated, our Minister of Poning gives you a 2% chance on this one.
You got this, Jeff. You can make that jump. Oh, backtracking? There you go.
Yeah, there's kind of a nice symbiosis going on in your shows, you know, where you, if you wanted to, you could use your failures from Achievement Horse in Fails of the Week. That way you'd never be short of material.
Yeah, we have so many fails to go through, too. I try to go through once every other week or so and pull down about 100 or so and kind of look through them, but even pulling down 100 at a time, we have how many tens of thousands now?
I don't know exactly how many we have left, but I can give you a mark. We started Fails of the Week in September of last year, and our inbox that we're working with all the submissions, we're on October of last year.
Yeah.
Oh, no, what's going on?
Oh, crap.
Hey, Pete, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
What did I do to you?
I just feel like this kind of stuff brings out your best material, you know? I'm trying to inspire you guys.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Inspire? Is that the word you want to use? I'm sorry, like, I hit a point, I don't know where to go.
Yeah, it's rough for you. I feel bad.
Looks like Jeff's making a run for it here.
I think I got this figured out. Ah! I bounced off it wrong.
No.
Ah! Death montage! Oh, I hope this is the right way.
Looks promising.
I think I may have this. Oh, right.
Woo! Oh, yeah.
Only right after all that humiliation that Jeff wins round two.
So, Damien, let me ask you a question. How many of these have you completed?
Oh, I'd do them all.
Oh, okay.
I wouldn't make you guys do them, you know, if I hadn't. So, what you have to do here is to use the golf ball as a jumping point to get to the other side where part two of the challenge awaits you.
Oh, this is brilliant. Oh.
Come on.
Yeah, these are really great maps.
Yeah, these are really well done.
Oh. Gonna do it? First try?
I think you get an assist from Jack's corpse there, but there's nothing in the rule book about that. Jack's turn again.
There you go.
You guys are better than I thought you'd be.
All right, so what exactly are we doing here?
Oh, did I forget to tell you about the kill zones on the other side? So in the second part of the golf ball challenge, you have to stand on the ball and roll it to the other side, you know, like a performing bear in the circus.
Going the wrong way.
No, that's just called not doing it right.
Is there a right way to walk on a golf ball? Whoa! Ah!
Ah, oh, Jack's delicate ballet of death. You guys really have the symmetrical thing going on. So it's probably not surprising that there are gamers out there who devote endless hours to Forge to make these great challenge maps, but the difference with Pete is that he actually has a child on the way.
Yeah.
Say goodbye to your Halo skills, Pete.
I know, right?
Hey, Jeff. Jeff, real quick, not to interrupt you, but I totally just beat this one.
Oh, did you?
So Jack takes round three, and Jeff gets an S. This could be the deciding round. So what you have to do is grab a jetpack and fly on over to the cave in the cliff.
All right, I think I see what I need to do. All right.
All right, totally got it.
And as you might guess, the jetpacks don't last nearly long enough to make it.
What's your take on this, Jack? Are you going to go around or under?
Around.
I tried to go around, too.
There we go.
Oh, you got it.
Go, Jack.
I think Jack sees a beacon out there in the distance. And he got the power up.
Oh, we got it.
Oh, shit, there's another one.
Oh, how about that?
You missed it.
Oh, come on! So, there's a power-up somewhere right here. I don't see it, though.
I'm cheating. I'm gonna jump out of here.
You are cheating. Oh, man, you took the ball. I couldn't get it. How dare you? You just said, I'm cheating. I'm jumping ahead of you.
Look who just landed.
What's up? Was it on the one
What's
you cheated
up?
On?
I'm over here.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The one where you said, hey, I'm going to cheat, and then I'm going to cheat.
I think we're going to have to count that one, Jeff. So that's TSL for you, and for Jack, victory. Guys, thanks so much for joining us. It's been a blast.
Hey, thanks so much for having us.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man. It was a lot of fun.
Jeff, can you give us an idea what's coming up from Rooster Teeth?
But yeah, we'll have Season 9 of Red vs. Blue will be starting up sometime this year. Then new Achievement Hunter videos every day. New Fails of the Week and Horse every week.
Cool. So because the last win was debatable, we'll switch things around and let Jeff do the honors here.
Oh, awesome.
You get to choose Jack's demise. Is it the very quick kill ball? The explosive second choice? Or try to stay on the die while it sinks and fall off and drown?
I'm going to go for the die.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the die is especially poetic because it seems to allow him to hold on to some hope, but it really just extends his agony.
The agony of success, right?
I don't expect this to go well for me, but okay.
Congratulations, Jack.
Oh, look at him. Wait a minute. Wait. He's fighting it. He's a survivor. But.
You can do it. You can do it.
Oh, that's sinking.